At present, over 1.5 billion websites are there on the World Wide Web, and more than 50,000 websites get hacked every day. So, what is the way out? Today's video is on website security, more precisely data transfer security over the internet. If you are interested, please continue watching. Hello, this is Ananya Banerjii and you are watching my channel Youandimpact. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to get regular updates.
We do not have all day.
Today's subject is very profound. It requires several technical terms to give you an in-depth knowledge. But I will try to avoid the jargons and explain it in most simple way. You may be a common internet user or have your own website. My aim is to make you aware of the basic security measures. When we browse any website, on the top of the browser, you see "Not Secure" is written. And sometimes you see "Secure" with a lock icon. Any idea? What does it mean? Yes, this information is all about data transfer security of the website. Let us first understand what is data transfer security. When we open any website, some data is transferred from the web server to our computer or mobile web browser. This way, we can view a website. Again, when a user gives input to a website by submitting a login form or sign up form, then some data is transferred from web browser to web server. This type of data transfer can happen in two possible ways. One, using HTTP protocol, and two, HTTPS protocol.
This is not a philosophy class. Un do words ka matlab batao bas.
Yes. Let me explain HTTP protocol. The full form of HTTP is hypertext transfer protocol. In this protocol, data is transferred in human readable open text format. So this data is open to all and is exposed to the hacker. This type of hacking is called MITM, man in the middle attack. Here the hackers can get access to the sensitive information of the website like username, password, credit card details, etc. They can even modify the web page by injecting malware and advertisements. To prevent this kind of attacks, network engineers designed another safest way to transfer the data. So here comes the second option. Number 2, data transfer using HTTPS. Here S stands for secure. In this HTTPS protocol, the data is transferred in an encrypted format. It uses SSL certificate to transfer the data. The full form of SSL is secure socket layer. It creates the secure encrypted connection between web server and web browser. That is why this protocol is often called HTTP over SSL. I will not go much deeper into this matter because these technical terms may seem to you like jargons. You just remember data transfer in HTTPS is secure. Nowadays, HTTPS is considered as a basic security measure of a website. All the popular websites are using HTTPS. To use HTTPS for your website, you have to purchase and install SSL certificate into your hosting server. Google has taken a strong position on web security. From July 2018, Google is marking all the HTTP websites as not secure and HTTPS websites as secure in their Chrome browser. Consequently, all the HTTPS websites are getting priority in the Google search engine ranking. Now the bad news is that HTTPS only cares about the data transfer security. It cannot protect a website 100%. The website is still vulnerable to the other types of attack like cross-site scripting, SQL injection, etc. but surely it provides a basic security measure to a website. That's all for today. If you have any question, please write down below. Subscribe my channel. I will see you in the next video. Please like this video if it is helpful to you and share among your friends on social media, WhatsApp groups, so that it may help others as well. See you soon in the next video. Bye. Give me some rain. Give me another chance. I wanna grow up once again. Give me some sunshine. Give me some rain. Give me another chance. I wanna grow up once again.